All right, welcome back to the Club Car body removal. I think it's part two, so we're gonna work on the rear of the body here and getting that off. On the last video, we did the front. That was pretty easy. This one should go as easy, except for the forward reverse selector. Like I said, these are always a pain and seized on. This one does not even have the screw in it. So what we're gonna do, we're just gonna cut it off with the old Dremel. Got my safety glasses on, so we'll give a whack at that and see if we can get it off. I went ahead and used a pry bar, a few things to try to get that off, see if we can save it. But I mean, it's old and faded, so I think a jockey shift's like 20, 25 bucks on Amazon. So we're just gonna cut that off there. We just have to be careful because the bolt that holds it on the backside, we don't wanna cut into that. So we're gonna slowly kind of work at the plastic around there and see if we can wiggle that off as easy as possible. And then we'll get to the bolts, hoping that none of them are rusted out or too bad, so we have to drill those. So it should just take about an hour or so, give or take. We'll speed this up a little bit to get through the process of getting the rear off, and then we'll get it stripped and ready for paint. So bear with us, and hopefully we can figure out how to edit the video and speed up the cutting process so you don't miss so you miss the cuss words and all the frustration that sometimes goes into this. So here we go. We'll set you over here. Get a nice view. We'll get to cutting. So what I'm trying to do here is not get close to the body and cut the body, of course. So I'm gonna score it in a whole bunch of spots to see if I can just pry it right off. See if I can get in there, if that'll give us enough relief to get this this rusted old shifter off here. It's really no rhyme or reason, I'm just cutting at it. Crank it up here. Mm-hmm.
Slowly coming.
Big chisel.
Yeah, it needs a little more cutting.
All right, we finally got her off. Good riddance to you. That thing is rusty and crusty. We'll clean it up with the Dremel, polish it up, and then we will thread that again and see if that even works. So, oops, I had it in reverse. There we go. One part done. That only took an hour. All right, so we were chipping away at this, but as you see, that's why these do not come off easy. It has been rusted and just seized onto there, made it part of the shifter itself. So what we're gonna attempt to do is keep doing relief cuts and then slowly chipping off parts of that plastic. And hopefully we can get down to the bottom collar of it and it is not as rusted on there. And then we will run a tap back through there, clean up those threads, and hopefully you'll receive a screw again. I don't have to replace that whole thing. So we're gonna be gentle and take our time with getting this off. So these are those things that you run into that if you quote some time, or if you're at home, you're like, oh, I could take that body off in an hour. This is probably gonna be an hour, hour and a half, just in slowly grinding this thing off, getting it cleaned up, just to get the body off to prep for paint. So just keep that in mind. All right, so now that pain in the butt's done, we can move on to our screws here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These shouldn't be as bad. So these are just simple screws. Unfortunately, that thing took us forever. So we'll clean that up at some point. We're gonna see if we can get these off a little easier. Yeah, that's coming right out. So instead of using a drill, I like to use a hand tool with these because as you can hear, the nut just fell out of that. Nope, now it's on the floor. I'm always dropping my nuts here. There we go. There's one. Bottom ones, if anything's rusted, it's usually these because there's not a nut on the back side, it is actually a threaded part of the frame. Top ones don't look too bad. We'll probably replace these bottom ones with some nice stainless. Like I said, this whole assembly comes out. I'll do a close-up of that here in a minute, and I'll show you what that looks like. We just kind of set that off to the side. But be careful, those nuts are still there. And we'll need to collect those. All right, and our last one here. So it looks to be in good shape. And it didn't bite much, so we're good. All right, so I'll show you what the cluster looks like here. So just be careful with those nuts. We'll take those off and we'll put those in our dish as well and save them. So, and then next we're gonna be taking off the rear seat. The bias should come right off, so stay tuned. All right, this is your bag well. So under here, what I do is I just take a screwdriver, just pry up a little. There's a spot for both there to hold the back of the body on. And that one's gone. So we're going to pop this one up. And there we go. And that is our last piece that is holding this whole body on. We'll get that off, we'll take the body off, and we'll be good to go. All right, so of course, being the last nut and bolt to come out of this thing, it was stripped. So this has been painted in the past. So somebody's taken this off, and they left this one out, and this one clearly is stripped. But this is where all the water collects and sits under these little pieces here. So I've hit my hand with the hammer about 6 times. You know, a smart guy would just drill it out. But, you know, I'm not that guy. I'm just going to keep wrenching on it and see if I can get it broke loose on the bottom. More to come. All right, so we got all of our bolts done. Removed, finally. Should just be able to pick it up. So the backwards, I'm gonna unplug. Quick connects here. Where the brakes. You know, I got might want to do that before they take the body off. I'll set this over the side and start this prep. Now we can dig into the motor a little engine and get it cleaned up. Looks pretty good, really, so for the year and the wear that's been on the car. I always like to check the ramps on the clutch here. Those look fine to me. You know, we could even, while we have it off here, put a heavy duty clutch spring in there for the guy. Get a little more torque. Yeah, everything looks good inside. So, yeah, we'll get it cleaned up. We got hit some bad weather, unfortunately. But, you know, we'll get it cleaned up and everything looking a lot better for him. And that's in the body off the paint. Should be it.
Got her all stripped down. Got her choke button taken off here. That thing's all chewed up. I did that last time. And then we took off our fasteners for the front seat. And then this bar right here, I'm just gonna go ahead and rip that out because it usually ends up getting lost. I might leave it on there, I don't know. We got the tail lights taken off. And then we're just gonna get those headlights off and we will be good to take it to paint after work today. So try to scrape some of this stuff off too for the guy, for the paint guy. I'm gonna make it as easy as possible so you can just sand it, prime it, spray it. It'll be a nice pretty blue color. That's what they're going for.
Well, today it's like 50 and sunny, so we're going to take advantage of this beautiful day and clean off the car. We're gonna use this aluminum cleaner and restore. So this stuff, since the club car is all aluminum body, chassis rather.
All right, got it looking pretty good. Since this dash part is where you're gonna be able to see, I cleaned it up and I'm gonna use that compound to see if I can get it shiny like the steering wheel. I think with enough buffing might be able to. So I'm gonna dry it off and then try the that chrome cleaner, see what happens. Oh yeah, this stuff's amazing. Almost a mirror-like finish from a dull aluminum over here. Look at that. I mean, it's labor intensive. This does take time, but the result's really cool. I can't speak to this stuff enough. It turned the dull aluminum to a chrome mirror-like finish. So this is the only trim you're gonna see, so I'm just focusing on that. I also tried out on the support brackets up here as well. Those are near black when I started, so. A little elbow grease and the right compound. I think it's gonna be nice. All right, we're gonna install the brackets that the seat goes on, but they're overspray from the last job they had this done. I can't send it out like that, so we'll painstakingly scrape these off, polish them up so everything looks good. See, this is, I just go above and beyond everything I do. That's why it takes forever to get stuff done. But if you clean this, you fix this, and you gotta clean that and fix that. So I love doing it, don't get me wrong. But you know, we're not your fastest shop, but we'll do you right.
Oh no, don't use the scraper on me. Oh, oh, please no.
That is much better with the other side on, but those things are. Nice and bright. Coming along. All right, so I just want to do a really quick video. This is a Club Car DS that I've been working on, nicknamed Cinderella. So these T-nuts are always a pain. You can really just back them out a little and take the body off, but I always find myself just taking them off because I clean up the chrome and stuff, well, aluminum, to make it look like chrome. So old trick is using some toothpicks to kind of get them to stay because they just slide up and down. And once you get this one done, you're not gonna be able to find this one. So to keep this one stay in the position, I'm going to wiggle this one up, put the nut in, or put the bolt in. All right, making lots of progress here tonight. Instead of those junky little push pins, I went ahead and put some aluminum bolts and nuts on there. We got the new headlights in. Alright, our new Ford reverse switch. Everything all shiny. New snubber put in. There wasn't a snubber, so just put a snubber in there. We got our nice clean painted plastics here. Got two more bolts to go here. And then we'll put the Bagwell plastics on. These LEDs are real nice. The other ones are just falling apart. So we got that, and then we're gonna install the back seat. And then 20 bolts later, we'll be down the road. Clean up the seat and stuff a little bit. So but yeah, it turned out pretty good. The Cinderella, that's the name of this car.